So it was just a simple argument at the dinner table that led
it
to
was
this?
On July 6, 2006, we had a bad argument at the table about broccoli, just like in the movie.
Yeah. And I don't blame you, by the way.
And he said something not so nice about his mom.
And which will never be repeated.
That
no, we're not going to talk about exactly what he said. And it ended very badly. No.
No.
Can't say that. It ended very badly, it was a bad night, and I wrote the book that night as a way to explain to him how moms are special. And it didn't occur to me to actually turn it into a book until much later, when it worked so well as a parable for him,
yeah,
that it might work as a book and might work as a movie.
And as a movie.
And then 4 years later, what do you know?
And that's what happens. Yeah. So actually now, every time you're bad, does it become a book?
Yeah, he'll be rewarded every time he's bad. Yeah. So what am I teaching my kid? This is terrible. Don't listen to anything.
So how did they do?
With the movie?
Yes.
The spectacular. I didn't... Listen, when you write a book and then you go through the screenplay process, which I didn't do, but I read the screenplays and I watched Seth and Joan film the motion capture scene at the end that's so sad 3 times, and still by the time 4 years later I see the movie, I blubbered like a baby. Yeah, I mean, I wrote the stupid scene. It was very, very embarrassing that I'm sitting there crying. And my son turned around and said, that is pathetically pathetic for you to cry at your own story.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
But that it means something's working. So we were very excited.
And you just have another, I read a press release for another book of yours, another story.
My other book, Flawed Dogs, is at DreamWorks, being developed as a film, and I'll be an executive producer for that one.
Nice. So. Is that going to be another motion capture? Or what?
No, that'll be standard. Their DreamWorks Live, animation that they always do, the full animation, so it's CG animation.
Yeah.
And I'm sure, no doubt, 3D these days. So,
get another. Everything is 3D.
Yeah.
Are you a fan of 3D?
I'm a fan of 3D when they do it right.
Okay.
And I have to say that this movie, they did it right.
Okay.
I won't name them, but there's movies that I couldn't understand why I had the damn glasses on. No, I'm not going to name them. I'm in Hollywood, baby.
That's right.
You don't name anything. But I forgot I had the glasses on of Marcy's mom's, and I didn't see it in the big screen, the IMAX screen, and I can't wait to, because normally that would annoy me, but this movie really works on IMAX.